I guess the thing that I would like people to know about is being able to go back to Mother Earth to find healing. You know, we talk about our ceremonies as healing, have healing qualities to them, and being able to help a person overcome adversity in life. And really, all our ceremonies come from Mother Earth. Everything we have in life comes from her. And she's the greatest help we have. And she continues to help us every day and give us that blessing of a help. So much so, in fact, that the old people, they used to say, you know, if you tripped and fell on Mother Earth, you know, when you're a little kid and you trip and you fall, you get up and you'd try to clean yourself. They tell you, don't. She grabbed you and hugged you. That's your mother. You want to be proud of that. Let people know that you were blessed today by her. So it was a proud thing to have dirt on you. You didn't take the dirt off. You didn't try move it from your clothing or your hands or whatever. And that as a caring mother, when you're acting out or something, they'll just grab you and hold you and hug you, you know, and you straighten up and away you go. You know? And the same as Mother Earth, she's just sees you that day and says, oh, that one needs a hug, you know, and you slip and fall on her and hugs you close. That very thing is a healing thing for people to know that to touch her face, to touch her is a great blessing and a healing. So when we look at our healing ceremonies that come from Mother Earth, we sit on her when you go out and you fast. You're finding yourself out there. And it's a time for you when you do that fast. So you sit out there on Mother Earth and things come to you. Your ancestors will come to you. The animals will come to you. There's many voices that will appear for you, that they'll appear for you for song and prayer. And Mother Earth sends those to you, she brings that to you, and you're sitting on her. You're just sitting right out there on her. And it's a time to be with her, and she holds you and cradles you in those 4 days to find yourself, to find out who you really are. And the Creator says, take a look. You like yourself? That's important. That's a healing thing. So when you're wandering in a quest and wanting to know, well, how do I access that stuff? How do I go to ceremony? We even looking at our sweat lodge ceremony. Well, you just go back to Mother Earth. If you have no other way of doing anything, just go to her, and she'll take care of you. She gives you the things that you need. She knows you. She knows everything. Everything from the time the world ever began. Everything's happened on her. So she knows it. And there's nothing that ever happened anywhere in the world that she doesn't know. There is no one who's ever walked, talked, cried, or sat on her that she doesn't know. Every single person born, she knows. Because your body was created by Mother Earth. As our parents created us, as we come into be, what they ate helped build who we are, our body. The Creator gave us our spirit. And at that point in time, when the spirit and body met, there was a silent sonic boom. And when that boom occurred, that's when our ego was laced onto the body and our spirit laced it together. And when we go, it's the first thing that will unravel and leave us is ego. We become, you know, you sit with people who are leaving. They become very humble in this life before they go. That ego just dissipates, and you're left with body and spirit then. And body, of course, goes back to Mother Earth. And spirit, it continues, just like it did before. It's then free. And when you really want to nurture your spirit and find the things that you need in this life to help you overcome whatever problem it is, whether it's an addiction or whether it's other things in your life, well, she's there to help. The Creator gave this beautiful, beautiful woman with so many talents and so many abilities and so many medicines. Just smelling some of them will set your mind right. Just go out and smell the sage. Smell the sweet grass out there. You don't have to pick it and braid it and set it alight, you know. Just sit out there and smell that. And there's people that'll say, I can't find it, I can smell it. That's a gift too. It's because you can't find it, you know, isn't a reason for you not to go out and smell what she's giving you. That in itself, that smelling it, is helping you. And sometimes those older things out there, older brothers and sisters, if we listen to them, they give us songs. They give us, and every day those little birds will sing. And we're not offering anything back to them. That's when we're supposed to put our tobacco down and say to them, thank you for that song. And listen really close to them, because they're giving you that song to help you nurture that spirit within you. And it makes your body tread lightly on Mother Earth. We're supposed to walk on her like a bear or a cougar. We have padded foot, just like them. So we're supposed to walk lightly on Mother Earth. And doing those things will make that body work, walk lightly on Mother Earth. So when you go out and you put down tobacco, and you thank those older brothers and sisters for nurturing your spirit, because those little songs are for. And those little birds, they see high above you, you know, they fly way high above, and they see over that horizon. So they are letting you know what kind of a day you're having, what kind of a day it's going to be. And they're singing a song. They're singing. And if you get up early, early in the morning, like I say, you know, my first breakfast was oatmeal, so I have three. But that time before the sun rises, those little birds are singing. They start singing. As they're singing to the sun in joyfulness and thankfulness that it's there and it's going to rise for us. So we should be prepared and ready to welcome that light into our life, and, you know, rejoice in that, because it's the thing that helps us. And you know, you get sad if you don't have the sun. It's really a fact that people don't do well without sunlight. So we should be out there enjoying every time it comes up and celebrating that. And your life then follows a good path when you take a look at the things that we have, the songbirds, the wind. When it's a windy day, go walk out in the wind. It untangles your mind. If you got a problem, it'll be over when you get back. You'll know where you should be going by then. And going back to Mother Earth just means that. Just look at the things that she has that helps her. The wind and the sun. We have the rain. And you go out in the rain, or listen to the rain. Listen to the rain on a roof. It's very soothing. Listen to a waterfall. Listen to a river. Those things are there to help us to set us on a good course in life. And it's not something to be ignored. Those are very powerful things. If you listen and you touch and you feel and you gather that strength by touching, feeling, smelling, listening. They're all good things for human beings. And when we do that, we put our ego behind us instead of letting it carry you through life. You don't go far with that big I am dragging you along. As people battle their addictions, it's really, they're battling themselves. They're battling all the false ideas that they've placed upon themselves as who they are. And when we take them into healing places, whether that be into a sweat lodge, into a talking circle, into a fasting, or if they go into dancing and they take up powwow dancing, or they go to one of our sacred lodges, or if they're in a sun dance or a rain dance, or attend those things, it's peeling those layers and ideas off of them so that it gets down to the real nut, you know, of who they are, the core of who they are. And they can build and build on that again in a good way, because it's like peeling layers off of something, saying this isn't, it's a false layer, that's not you. It's a false layer, it's not you. Then they build the layers that are really themselves, that they can take with them out there into the future, and they can be an inspiration to other people. Not because people want to be the same as them, but they want to be able to have joy in their heart and enjoy them and rejoice in their spirit being free when they get rid of their addictions. That's what you really find when you go through our ceremonies. And that's what it brings to them.